What's up YouTube, today I'm going to show you guys how to make YouTube thumbnails in Photoshop. So guys, I have a quick challenge for you. If you could like this video in the next 5 seconds, you will get a whole week of good luck. Trust me, the luckiest things will happen to you, so give it a try. And without talking much, let's get right into the video. So first of all, open Photoshop, it doesn't matter what version you have, and then make a new image by going to File and New. Then change the resolution to 1920x1080. Make sure that it is selected pixels and leave other things like it is and hit OK. Now for the background, what I normally use is polygonal backgrounds because I think they are way much better than normal backgrounds. So you have to keep a certain color theme for each thumbnail. For this thumbnail I will select purple. Make sure that you type the correct keywords in the search. As an example, I will type purple polygonal background. Choose an image you like and download it. So when I make my thumbnails, I always try to place a cool character to match my theme. So in this case, I will select Stratus in Fortnite because it matches my color theme. When you search the image in the Google, make sure to use the keyword PNG. It simply means transparent. As an example, Stratus skin Fortnite PNG, and then download the image. Make sure that it is selected as a PNG, and you can verify it if you see small white boxes around the picture, it's a PNG. Now come back to Photoshop. Now place the purple background by going to File, Place. For resizing, hit Ctrl plus T. For a quick tip, hold shift while resizing the image, it keeps the image still while resizing. Now again place your character and resize it. Now type your text. You can activate the text tool by hitting T on your keyboard and resize it by hitting Ctrl plus T and holding shift while resizing it. After you have written all your text and resized it, now it's time to add some effects to your text. You can do it by going to your text layer and right click and going to blending option. In there you can add a drop shadow, stroke and etc. I will only add a stroke and a drop shadow and a gradient overlay. Instead of adding effects to every layer one by one, you could copy and paste the layer style. You can do it by right clicking the layer, copy layer style and then paste layer style. Do it for all the text layers. Now if you want my gradient overlay, make sure to select the same colors I have in those boxes. And then right click the layer style and go to blending options and check the gradient overlay box. Now select the gradient box and select the number 1 preset. Now you can copy and paste the layer styles. Now what I normally do is I also add a white stroke and a drop shadow for my character. So go ahead and add white stroke and drop shadow. You can do it by right clicking the layer and then by going to blending options. You can mess up with these settings until you satisfy your image. Now you are pretty much done. But what I normally do is I add white border for the image. To do that, save your image by going to File and Save As and save as a JPG. Then again make a new image by the resolution of 1920x1080. And then place the thumbnail by going to File, Place. Now while holding Shift, drag it a little to the left. Do it in a manner that it creates a white border. And hit enter and then save it as a JPG. So there you have it, your own custom thumbnail. If this video helps you out, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe to this channel, and make sure that you complete the challenge so you will have amazing luck. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.